What is going on, everybody, on the USK Gaming channel? It is your boy Savage here, back with a brand new video. I know we haven't even uploaded for a week now, or probably 6 or 5 days. We're sorry, we're gonna be back on this grind. I know we keep saying it, but this time it should be more consistent now, man. Obviously, there's still some people in the team that's in school right now, so like videos can't really get pushed a lot. But sometime during this month, a lot of people is gonna be out of school, so we should be a lot more content coming out for you guys. And also, let me know down below in the comments if you guys are out of school right now. So if you guys are out of school, make sure you just comment down below. And if you guys are still in school, let me know if you guys are still in school. Right now, I'm currently still in school till June 27th or the 6th. So that just goes to show you guys that I'm really busy right now, especially me failing almost every single class. But let's get into the video. Make sure you guys do follow us on all social medias like Twitter and Instagram. Links down below in the description. And make sure you guys enter in our Gleam.io giveaway down below too as well. But today we got a brand new gun that has been leaked. It's going to be a brand new launcher. Finally getting a brand new launcher in the game, since we only had two launchers, which was the rocket launcher and the grenade launcher. We basically don't get a lot of brand new launchers when it comes to Fortnite. I think the last one was the quad launcher, which was pretty OP because you guys will be able to spam it. And this one sounds pretty OP too as well, from what I'm reading from the stats and all that. But I'm pulling up the article for what it says. It says a first look at the leaked proximity launcher coming to Fortnite Battle Royale. It says there have been many periods in Fortnite history where weapons are introduced at a high power level and must be nerfed, if not removed entirely. Now there is a new weapon on the horizon, and it seems like this one could be quite strong. We reported on the proximity launcher just yesterday, but at the time it wasn't clear if it was just a STW exclusive, and we didn't have any more files besides a picture. Now we have an in-game render from Crispy Leaks of new weapons to share. Now shout out to Crispy Leaks. I'm gonna show you guys the video right now of the in-game. It's kind of like gameplay of it, except that he's actually not picking it up, but you guys can actually see gameplay in-game on how it will look and all that as well. I'm gonna show you guys some pictures right after, so I'm gonna show you guys the video and be right back. So as you guys can see from the video, it's an epic variant of the proximity launcher. Honestly, looks pretty dope. Pretty small gun for a rocket launcher. You guys would expect that to look like an assault rifle. Kind of reminds me of the burst gun, kind of, on the way how it's set up. Like the FAMAS, not the 3-round burst one. And I'm gonna show you guys an image on how it will look in different type of games of this specific launcher. If you guys are familiar with weaponry of launchers or guns over on other games, this is kind of looking like the XM25. I'm gonna show you guys an image of that gun and put it besides the proximity launcher, and you guys will see it kind of looks alike. And I'm gonna show you guys the stats right now of the brand new gun. As you guys can see, it says damage 70, crit change is 0%, fire rate is 0.65, which is pretty good for a rocket launcher, don't get that twisted. Magazine size is 2, so most likely guys will be able to spam it just like the quad launcher, except that this one kind of has more damage than the quad launcher, I think. If I'm wrong, let me know down below. And also, ammo type is going to be rocket. So as you guys can see, the stats are pretty good for rocket launchers, not better than an actual rocket launcher, but the other rocket launcher that's in the game, you guys have to keep reloading, except that this one has 2 inside the magazine already. So that just goes to show the difference when it comes to the rocket launcher. This one you can probably spam it a little bit, not as much as you guys can do with the grenade launcher or the quad launcher, but you guys know what I mean. And also, I'm gonna show you guys an image of how it will look in game on a character's hand, as well with a camo variant in the game, which is a wrap. So as you guys can see, this gun is really small for a rocket launcher, like I said before, but also at the same time seems pretty dope and cool. And finally, like I said before, just us getting a brand new rocket launcher, and just Fortnite overall just adding brand new guns, keeping the game alive and changing the meta. So basically it makes this game really fun and lasting. I haven't really been playing lately just because the fact I got school, but I do want to get back into playing it a lot. It seems like it's not at its best stage from what I see on Twitter, but overall, like, I still get into my zone while playing Fortnite, man. So let me know in the comment section down below, how do you guys feel about Fortnite Fortnite right now in its current stage. Is you guys liking Fortnite or not? And tell me how you guys feel about the brand new proximity launcher. Do you guys think it's a W or L? Or do you guys think that they should add a different weapon variant, not a rocket launcher? I feel like they should add one. We just only got two rocket launchers, while we got like 4 or 5 assault rifles, 2 or 3 SMGs, and other weapons, and not a brand new launcher. But if you guys did enjoy the video, make sure you guys do drop a like. Subscribe to the channel if you guys are new. That would really mean a lot. And make sure you guys do follow us on our all socials down below. Make sure you guys do enter in our Gleam that I will give away for 1,000 V-Bucks. And that'll be all for this video. It's been your boy Savage, and I'm out.
And then there goes the redeploy. This should give him opportunity to set up. One's going to be right next to him as well. And Twins is going to box up right away. Safety campfire, needs to continue to protect himself. Doesn't have the shield, so needs to take a moment to pop a few minis there. Jarvis is going to be right outside of him. And then Smeefy as well as Nath P5 right next to them. Lachi is going to be above. And this is Twins now just looking to see if he can pick off an elimination. Player right in front. He charges forward. He's got a few builds he's got to fight out of here and does manage to get on out.
I love that. He knew he did not. He wasn't in a great spot to take the fight. He's more concerned about getting himself to safety. He's going to go ahead and drop another campfire, just again making sure every single resource he has is as high and as valuable as it can be. He's going to try to drop the player down and get out. Doesn't matter. Grav loses to gravity there. And now he's just going to continue his onslaught. I mean, look, you can tell, and I say this a lot, is you can tell what a player's thinking just by the way they move. And right now, Jordan, he is just hunting. He is so hungry for more.
He wasn't even concerned about the purple combat shoddy that was right next to him. At this point, you're just playing with the kit that's there. You're more focused about defense, movement, recognizing where players are, rather than you are like, hey, should I switch out this weapon at this point in time? It's just not that necessary for Jordan at this moment. And there's going to be a player with the shadow bomb outside, and he gets on top of that mountain because he knows that the storm is going to be going that way. The safe zone is going to be inching ever so closely to that. So play for the high ground. Maybe you take a few ticks, but it's not the end of the world there. Jordan does recognize a player will be down low, tags him with the boombo, gets another one on to Smeefy. You have some players now looking to fight their way out of this one, and the ultimate high ground is going to be Lapix.
Oh my gosh, he's just commanding this spot right now. And look, Jordan dropped back down into the thick of things, trying to pick up more. Look, he's already on 7 eliminations. 2 more players left. He is in top 5. He's going to get those placement points of 7. And now he wants to try and close it out. But look up at the top left. Lapix finds another 1v1. Elimination. It's a 1v1. And this goes back to just all the training you do in playgrounds with your friends. This is coming out of that moment.
Well, the tables have turned here. In the last game, it was going to be Jordan that had the high ground, and then it was Vince down low, and he had that advantage. Meanwhile, Lapix is going to be the one that has the ultimate high ground here. Twins only is going to have 7 builds remaining. Meanwhile, Lapix has so much to work with, 66 builds. He's actually going to go down. I think he may have missed that opportunity to build the waterfall, but it's not going to really bother him all that much because Lapix still maintains the ultimate high ground. Meanwhile, Jordan still continuing to look around, seeing if Lapix is going to go in there for the fight. He's going to drop down and engage on him. They're both going to have the shotties in their hands here. Twins needs to be careful. He only has 1 more build remaining. Is this the moment that he was looking for? Lapix with the control up above, and then Twins needs to be mindful of not only Lapix above him, but also what's going on below him. He has no more builds remaining. Nothing left to work with here, and he's going to destroy the structure, and Lapix is going to catch himself with the redeploy, but they're both going to have it, so they glide on their way down, but Jordan's going to be there first, and he can make him pay for this one. Lapix is outside. He can't get back into the safe zone. It's ticking down, and that is going to be the victory royale for Jordan Twins IWNL, and that is how he secured his spot at the Fortnite World Cup Finals. That will take the stage, and they had, I mean, I saw Sundown tweeting very late at night, my friend.
Sorry.
Probably, you know, it's very clear that, you should be in bed, but it's okay. Maybe you're in bed watching the games.
That's actually what I was doing. I had on my work computer, had all the multi-box for everyone who was streaming, and then on my laptop, I was just kind of jumping through all the other games. Jordan from the X2 Twins taking home the top spot, clutched it up in his very last game. I mean, honestly, this match was absurd. Going into the last hour, the top 4 players, the top 3 were all tied at 52 points, and then one was right off the pace. Repulse got, or Zore was just off the pace at 51. And then the spread from first to 10 was like 8 points. So typically we've seen 1 or 2 players, particularly Volks and Parpy last week, just blow it out of the water. Wasn't the case here. Came down to the very last matches. And I actually want to check out Jordan's match history here so we can kind of get a look into what that looked like. And one thing that they stress big is game management and keeping a strong mental game. So first, right off of the bat, boom. 0 elims, 91st. That's rough. However, follows it right back up. Second, 10 Elims. First, 9 Elims. Sixth, 6 Elims. That's a fantastic run. And even here, getting 5 Elims in 28th, like, that's tough, leaving 3 points on the table, but the 5 Elims feels really good. The one thing I want to note here,